Hello everyone, I'm Lupiero, back again with another Awaken Chaos Era video. So in today's video, I'll be going over the latest patch notes that was released today, which is on the 10th of August 2022. So let's check them out together. So this is the update notice. And basically, the first thing that they have done is they have added 3 new legendary heroes who are Kasib, a wood affinity hero from the Crisis faction. Ayim is a water affinity legendary hero from the Dragonscale Marsh, and finally Fianna, a wood affinity hero from the Holy Light Empire. And finally, there's one new epic hero that was introduced, which is an Orki, a wood affinity hero from the Sylvan Woodlands. And apart from the introduction of these 4 new heroes, they also introduced an advanced summon rate up to increase the chances of summoning the new legendary hero, who is Kasim, at 300% rate up for a limited time. So probably this one will be the regular 7 days to get him during this 300% rate up. And apart from that, they have also introduced a new system, which is the Chosen Faction Challenge. So basically this one is you use a certain faction of heroes to complete the certain floors. And with this new system, they have also added 2 new gear sets, which is the forging materials that can be obtained from the Chosen Faction Challenge. So basically this new feature that they have introduced, basically you as a player, you need to farm some materials from there and use it to forge these 2 new gear sets. And apart from that, there's a new magic pass, which is the legendary hero of God Fairy. So rather than the starter heroes that we normally see, this time it's a new legendary hero. Basically, God Fairy was also a new hero that was released last time during the 300% rate up, similar to Kasim. And in addition to all of this addition of new features, new heroes, and magic pass, they also optimized some rules for the stack view in the hero interface. So basically, we were able to only stack like level 1 heroes, and now we can stack the same level heroes. And finally, they have already removed the ultimate skill animation for the Arena, Team Arena, and Sky Duel. I did not know that they had this condition need to be played 50 times. That's pretty strange, because I was in the impression from the previous patch that they will totally remove it. But this seems like it only will totally remove after playing it for 50 times. I can't wait for it to be... I mean, there's a feature to toggle this ultimate skill animation for all games rather than just Arena, Team Arena, and Sky Duel, especially for the current guild versus environment that is going on right now. Alright, so that's basically all of the update notice. So let's check out these 4 new heroes in the index. Alright, so this is the first legendary hero that we'll be looking at first, who is Kasim. He's currently located in the Crisis faction. So let's check out his overall design. So basically, he wears a large turban on his head, similar to like the it's very very luxurious turban with a lot of treasures on top of it, with some gold bags, golden chains and emeralds, as well as some crown. Probably this turban is to hide all of his loot that he have found in the treasure chest and placed on top of his head. And apart from that, he wields two long blades. He's a dual building hero, and I think that's basically it. So he's mostly like a treasure hunter of some sort. Alright, so let's check out his overall stats. He has a S rating for attack, A rating for critical rate, and B rating for health, defense, and speed. So basically he's an attacker hero who has a very low base speed, although it shows B rating for speed. Alright, so let's check out his overall abilities here. Let's start off with his trait, which is known as the Home Ground. Reduces damage from area damage enemy abilities by 30%. So this one is basically similar to Lydia, the hero who also has this functionality in her trait. And upon ascending him, he will gain this Grand's Dodge up at the start of the round and remove upon taking attacks. Cooldown is 3 rounds, so he will only be able to get this dodge up every 3 rounds. And this one is 100% dodge, which means that Maybe the first AoE nuke he can survive because he will dodge it. Basically, dodge is a buff that prevents him from even taking a damage at all. And I think probably this will also works for spells. Maybe spells will be dodged as well. And yeah. So basically, he has this defensive trait to protect him. Most probably is this one just really good for either PvP like arena or enemy boss AoE damage. Right, so okay, so this one is really good for arena. This one gives me a similar vibe as Lydia, because Lydia only has like 50% dodge in total, 35% from her trait and 50% from her basic ability, but this one is 100%, which makes him even more tougher compared to Lydia. Right, so let's check out his first trait, first ability, to see how it synergizes with his trait. So his basic ability is known as the Daggers of Plunder. Deals 150% damage to an enemy with a 50% chance to steal one positive effect while ignoring resistance. So basically, he does not need focus stats at all to steal the positive effect. However, it's only a 50% chance. Oh, so this will be probably good against like buff heroes like Yolanda, who places a large shield on the heroes, and Kasim can just steal that buff from the enemy, which increases his survivability from there. And not only that, he can also steal like attack up buff, defense up buff, or maybe the death immunity from Dark Nicholas, or from death immunity from, who's that girl, Garona. That would be also a possibility. However, I would not really depend on that, because it's kind of RNG involved, because it's a 50% chance rather than 100% chance. Alright, so let's move on to the second ability. Sixth Sense is a passive ability, removes a control effect upon any area damage. Enemy ability and counter attacks for 150% damage against whichever enemy has the highest attack. This character is next to act. Cooldown 2 rounds. So let's say if I were to use like someone, maybe like Luna Melissa. Luna Melissa applies the taunt and she also deals some damage. So does that mean it will instantly remove that taunt from Luna Melissa and then counter attacks? If that's the case, that would be really powerful. Yeah, that would be really powerful. Okay, deals 150% enemy highest attack. Wow, so basically this one is like, you can use Kasim in a go second team where you allow the team, the enemy team to go first. Maybe they buff themselves with some increased attack up and speed up buff from like wind strikes, then let them attack you. And his, what's this called, his home ground trait will have this dodge. If you I think if you ascend him to 2 ascension or 5 ascension, he'll be able to like avoid the damage or reduce the damage, the incoming damage by 30%, having to survive that, and then he can counter attack with his 6th sense. That will probably be another strategy. So currently what I'm seeing here is Ace developers are introducing heroes who are useful for go second arena team, something like that. That's pretty cool. And for the ultimate ability, Fatal Blow, which has a 4 turns cooldown, grants dodge up again, removes one positive effect and deals 200% damage to the target, which scales based on the amount of health loss and ignores element stats of the target. Ability cooldown shortened by 2 turns upon defeating a target. Wow, so basically, if you're able to defeat an enemy using this Fatal Blow, it cuts short the cooldown by 2 times, by two turns. So you can like quickly reuse it over and over again and keep on granting himself dodge to prevent from enemy from killing him. That's pretty good. But if I were to count on this positive effect, probably I'll need to build some focus stats on him, at least like 60-80% against like a mid to high resistance player. However, if the player has like 100-180% resistance, that would be probably quite difficult. So based from his overall skills on Kasim, he's most likely like an arena hero that's suitable for like go second team. you can use him as like a arena defensive nuker to like catch your opponent off guard and quickly nuke out their attacker hero using this sixth sense. So if the enemy teams only uses like fast cleave nuke team, and you have Kassim there, and probably you have a chance to like take down their most important nuker, then you like cripple their offensive capabilities there, which is quite useful. So mostly I see him as an useful for like the real-time arena or the 3v3 arena or the regular arena. So mostly he's an arena hero. Alright, so that's basically his skill kit. Let's move on to the next hero in the list. So here is Haim, the new legendary hero for the Dragon Scale Mage. Based from her hero introduction animation, it wasn't that captivating at all. It's quite bland. Hopefully the Ace developers can make it more like sparkling or more interesting, because that was the background was really like bland. There's nothing interesting compared to like the previous legendary hero like Tashil that has a very cool background as well as Gyronel. So hopefully they will be able to add more heroes in this faction, because Dragon Scale Mage has the least heroes, or one of the top 3 least heroes in the game. Alright, so let's check out Haim's character design. So basically she wields a long spear with some bluish tin and a sparkling gem inside it. And she has a cool water wavy hair. It's like a water theme. And she's like cyan and bluish and white. Very, very simple design. Alright. So she seems to be like a water team hero. Yeah, basically, yeah, she's a water affinity hero. Alright, so let's check out her overall stats. So she has an S rating for her attack, A rating for critical rate, and B rating for her health, defense, and speed. So basically similar stats like Kassim. Mm-hmm. Very low base speed. So probably she's an attacker hero, and probably she would be something similar to Kassim, because her speed is pretty low. Maybe useful for Go second team as well. So let's check out her trait and abilities. So her first trait is Sea Blessing, grants invincible for 1 turn. Upon taking massive damage, cooldown is 4 rounds, and once you ascend her, it reduces the cooldown from 4 rounds to 2 rounds. So this one reminds me the skill kit of like Brand the Brilliant, because once Brand the Brilliant receives a high amount of damage that can kill him, it triggers that invincible buff that prevents him from taking any damage. And this trait is now it's now propagated to a non-light and dark hero. Now we see this first trait in the water affinity hero here, which is Haim, which is pretty cool, which is 2 rounds. Alright, so basically you can, okay, so based from her trait alone, it seems that she's like a go second hero as well, because this trait synergizes with her speed, because her speed is pretty low. So probably she will take a high amount of damage first, then maybe she can counter attack with her other skills that I'll be going over here. So her basic ability is Torrential. This Torrential deals 100% damage to an enemy and grants attack up buff to this character for 2 turns. So this attack up buff only increases her attack by 30%. Very basic. There's like nothing much to it apart from just increasing her attack stats. Alright, so let's move on to her second ability here. Wave Rage, which is her special ability. And counter attacks dealing 80% damage to all enemies with a 50% chance of applying defense down for 2 turns. Cooldown is 1 round. So basically, this special ability can be only triggered once per round. And once there's an enemy who attacks her, she will perform an AoE attack and has a chance to apply defense down. That's pretty cool. So basically from her special ability and her trait, she's like a go second nuker, which is useful for defensive teams. And finally, her ultimate ability, Whirlpool of Fate, which has a 4 turn cooldown, deals 120% damage to all enemies and damage skills with this with the amount of team damage taken this round. Okay, so basically this one is another AoE attack, and the damage skills with the amount of team damage taken this round. So basically means like if Yeah, this will be quite awesome. So let's say if you set up your team to go second in arena, where the enemy tries to nuke all of your heroes and Haim survive with her trait Seed Blessing, she gains this invisible, then she counter attacks the enemy based on how much damage they have received during that round. So let's say if there are three allies of Haim is defeated by the enemies, those damage will be returned to the enemy and multiplied by 120%. That will be super powerful. If that's the case, right, then this also makes her quite useful against like guild versus environment bosses, like the big boss or the mini bosses. Wow, this is pretty cool. So I can see her, there's a two usage, either in arena as a defensive go second team, or in like PvE content for bosses like guild versus environment or the or conquering the tiles from there. This is pretty cool. And based from her skill kit here, her ultimate is an AoE attack as well as a counter attack. Probably you can gear her in every set to multiply the damage up to 50%. However, every set will only benefit for the first round of AoE attack. So let's say if the enemy attack her, then she will use her average 50% multiplier damage with her wave rage. However, her whirlpool of fate will not benefit from the every set. However, if you're lucky to have Haim to go first in the battle, then her whirlpool of fate will benefit from the every set. So there's a dual usage. You can use every set for either her counter attack or her ultimate ability. So based on her skill kit, she's probably good in both areas as well, PvE as well as PvP. So probably you can use every set. Every set will be good to increase her damage, or you can also use revival set to sustain her health. So probably like, let's say the enemy damage her, then you can heal her up back with revival set, then she can like survive long enough to regain this invisible up buff to increase her survivability in a lengthy battle. That's pretty good as well. Alright, so let's move on to the third hero in the list, with Fianna. So this is Fianna from the Holy Light Empire. So she's a wood affinity hero but has a red team around her. She's like a fire hero because her team is red and blonde, but this one is wood. Okay. Probably her team should be like fire hero of some sort. Very simple armor design. A very long sword. A sword reminds me about Tia, who's the like opposite of her. She's a wood water affinity hero, and this one is more like fire affinity, but she's positioned as a wood affinity hero. Okay, so let's check out her overall stats. She has an S rating for attack, A rating for health, B A rating for critical rate as well, and B rating for defense and speed. Oh, that's so interesting. She's like an attacker with high amount of health and high amount of speed. That's very interesting in comparison to the previous two heroes that we have looked at, which is Kasim as well as Haim. Alright, so this is very interesting, something new. Alright, so let's see what Fianna can do here. Her Fianna trait is a Warmongerer. Grants a shield with strength equal to 20% of max health for 2 turns upon gaining any positive effect. Cooldown is 1 round. Minus 6% damage taken before attacks, down to 30% per positive effect on this character. So, which means that if you're able to stack at least 5 positive effects on her, so minus 6% multiplied by 5 will take you to 30%. So, by having a lot of buff on her, this will reduce the damage intake from her trait of a Warmongerer here. Oh, that's pretty cool. And upon ascension, this will increase the further reduce the damage taken from 6% to 10% and up to 50%. So once she have 5 positive effect, that will be minus 50% damage taken. Wow. So she need to be synergizes with a supporter hero that provides a lot of buff like Bran, brand provides a lot of like attack buff, defense buff, and shield. Would each shield stack up with her shield as well? If that's the case, then this makes her very tanky as an attacker hero. And probably if you gear her in a guard set, this will also trigger her shield as well. So that means she have a shield from the guard set plus a shield from her trait, making her very tanky. Wow, that is really impressive. It's like a tanky nuker. I wonder how this trait synergizes with her overall skill. Probably her skills would either give her some stats to gain at least 50%, because it's quite difficult to get 5 positive effects on any hero in the game. Alright, so let's check out her skills here. So her first basic ability is Blended Strike. Deals 150% damage to an enemy and grants random stats up to this character for 2 turns. Wow, this is the first buff that was introduced in the game and implemented on this hero, random stats up. Previously, we have random stats down, which is first introduced in Abaddon and then introduced in epic heroes such as like Epina. And now we have random stats up, which is the opposite of that, random stats down. And this one increases the attack up, increases the attack stats, defense stats, speed, critical rate, critical damage. But it does not increase the focus and resistance. Either it's not included or it's not mentioned here. Okay. Alright, so let's check out her special ability. I'm not sure whether this one is not catered to focus and resistance, or they've forgotten to mention it. Either these two probabilities. Alright, so let's check out her next ability here, which is Dash, a passive ability that allows Yana to attack with an additional dash under 3 or more positive effects, dealing 120% damage to an enemy while extending their stats up positive effect by 1 turn. Cooldown is 2 rounds. Okay. Oh, I think I got what it means. So basically, let's say if Fianna attacks with Blended Strike, she'll be able to perform another attack with Dash if she has 3 or more positive effects. And this Dash will deal 120% damage and increases the buff duration on her for 1 turn. And this one can only trigger every 2 rounds. Okay. So if you want Fianna to attack multiple times within the 2 rounds, right, you need to pair her with at least a buffer hero such as like Joseph. Joseph is capable of applying 2 buff, attack up buff and defense up buff with 3 turns, with a 3 buff duration. And probably she can benefit from it as well. And this same applies to Bran. Okay, that's pretty cool. So she's more of a like a buff hero that amplifies her damage through buff. And finally, her ultimate ability, Unbridled, which is a 4 turns cooldown, grants a duplicate of all positive effects on any non-boss enemy and deals 250% damage to the target, grants invincible for 1 turn. Wow, this is another buff here. So basically, you can use this ultimate ability to copy the buff from the target that she attacks the enemy. However, this copy buff, right, does not apply to boss enemies, only non-boss. So this makes her less viable in PvE content such as like Arcane Dominator dungeons and No Man's Land dungeon, because most of the boss there does not apply much buff to themselves, except for Queen of Tides and Gemini Dragon. Gemini Dragon gets his buff through Fury when you attack him, and the minions provide the immune up buff as well as attack up buff or defense up buff, I think. So probably this skill, so based from her overall skill kit, her damage skills based on how many buffs she has, and she become more tanky with more buffs she has as well. And she's able to copy buff from other heroes such similar to Vance, an epic hero, and you can perform additional attacks. So basically she's like a mixture of like a tanky nuker who relies on heavily on buff. So basically that's it. And yeah, so basically I can see her being used in arena as well, most probably arena, as well as to clear maybe like void towers against enemies who relies heavily on buff, like void tower or the guild versus environment if there's any enemy hero that has a lot of buff applied to themselves. All right, let's move on to the final hero, the epic hero from Sylvan Woodlands. So this is Orki, who is an epic hero from the Sylvan Woodlands. So let's check out his character design. He is equipped with a wooden armor. I think it's imbued to him. It has a long shiny sword, a blue sword, iron sword. I think it's magical imbued. And he wears a grass cape around his back with some flowers. And has some green hair, not green hair, maybe green leaf. And some branches that looks like horns. And what's that on his tummy? Something shining like a leaf icon. Is it like, looks like an LED icon. Not sure what does that mean. Maybe it means something. But it looks pretty weird on his tummy that is shining there. Alright, so let's check out his overall stats. He has an A rating for attack and critical rate, B rating for speed, and C rating for health and defense. So probably he's just a regular attacker nuker that doesn't have much tankiness in him at all. So let's check out his abilities, whether he has any abilities that helps him to sustain during the battle. So his first ability, his first trait is known as the Trend Ruff. Reduces attack damage taken by 40%, and then counter attacks with Trend Punishment. Cooldown is 3 rounds. And once you ascend him, he will further reduce the damage taken from 40% to 60% and grants himself an attack up buff for 2 turns and then counter attacks with Trend Punishment. Alright, so basically his ascension increases his survivability in reducing the damage taken from the enemies from both single target as well as AoE attack. Does that mean that he is able to only counter attack every 3 rounds? If that's the case, right, then that's pretty not so useful at all. Alright, so let's check out this hidden skill here, which is Trend Punishment. So basically this Trend Punishment is the skill that performs the damage for the counter attack. So this Trend Punishment deals 80% damage that skills based on the amount of damage mitigated by Trend Ruff. And then this 50% splash damage to other enemies. And so once you ascended this trait, it still deals the remaining damage as well. It's basically 80% and 50% splash damage. Nothing different here after ascending him. So this one, I think this one synergizes with his Trend Ruff. So the more damage he reduces, those damage will be reflected through his counter attack and also splash damage, which is pretty good here. It reminds me about a dark hero, I think, Augustine, who also is capable of doing this splash damage. Alright, so let's check out his basic ability here. So his first basic ability is Wood Spike, that deals 120% damage to an enemy and grants himself a defense piece up to this character for 2 turns. Defense piece up is a really useful buff to against a defensive hero that has high amount of defense to reduce the damage. So having this, right, is quite good in like ignoring those defenses and dealing damage to their health directly. And this is his passive skill, Growth Shield. 100% chance to gain 1 bonus turn upon defeating an enemy. Wow, this passive skill is really useful. Which means that if he is able to defeat any enemy using his ultimate ability or basic ability here, then he will instantly gain another turn to perform another attack. Oh, so if you do not upgrade this skill, it's an 80% chance, and once you upgrade it, it's a 100% chance. And finally, his ultimate ability is a 3 turn cooldown. Imbibing Strike removes all negative effects, deals 200% damage to an enemy, and recovers health equal to 40% of the damage dealt. Wow, okay. So if you're able to build him with a high amount of attack stats, critical rate, critical damage, and keep on defeating his enemies with single target attacks, he will be able to quickly gain more bonus turn and quickly reduces his ultimate strike cooldown, which makes him quite useful to deal massive amount of single target damage to an enemy. So basically his skill kit here is mostly like arena as well, deal a lot of damage to an enemy with single target and also counter attack them with some splash damage. So probably you want to build him with triple warrior sets and probably some, maybe like I think yeah, either full warrior set or maybe some curse set to allow him to deal some damage with this. Because curse set will be able to proc this defense space up, so his next attack will be able to ignore those defenses. So probably I'll just build him with full attack. Or if you have an additional curse set or what's it called, assassin set, then probably you also can benefit from this as well. Yeah, I'm not sure whether divine set will be useful for him, because divine set, I'm not sure whether divine set will also proc this defense space up. I know for sure curse set will proc, but I'm not so sure whether divine set will do something similar to curse set. Because there's some flaws with divine set where sometimes divine set counter attack but does not apply the negative effect on the enemy. Alright, so that's the end of the video. Do let me know which new hero that interests you the most. Is it Kasim, Ayim, Fianna or Orki? I'll be performing my own shard summoning in the next video, so if you do not want to miss out, click the subscribe button and as well as hit the notification bell to stay up to date. If you enjoy my first impression video, do give this video a thumbs up. And also check the video description below for some promo codes that you can redeem for some in-game resources for this month of August. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!